Good morning, everybody. Bonjour à tout le monde. Thank you for the invitation to the DTIP 2020 conference. And I am really pleased to present you a high vacuum wafer level packaging for uncooled infrared sensor. In this presentation, we will have an overview on the infrared market and the main technologies used today, together with an introduction of the TMOS infrared sensor. Later on, we will have an insight on the wafer level package and the vacuum level measurements completed on this sensor. And to conclude, we will have conclusions and time for questions, if they are any, from your side. So the infrared market is in expansion. There are many applications for infrared sensing and detection. So only to mention some of them, we can think about presence and motion detection, smart building management, and temperature sensing. And also, a strong boost is expected from the introduction of infrared sensing in robotic cars in the following years. So main technologies used today for uncooled infrared sensors are divided in three families, which exploit each of one a different transducing mechanism. So from one side we have pyrodetectors, which exploit the pyroelectric effect. Then we have the thermopiles, which exploit the seebeck effect, and microbolometers, which exploit the change of resistance of the layers inside. So a novel uncooled infrared sensor is presented here, dubbed TMOS. So actually, there has been a lot of publication on this device in the last years, and basically it is based on a thermally isolated suspended transistor. So the core element of the device is a suspended transistor, which is then holded through some arms to the frame, and the transducing mechanism of this device is related to the modulation of the current voltage characteristics of the transistor, which are modulated by the infrared radiation and thus the heating of the device. So the thermal conductance is a key factor for this device, in the way that if we want to have a high sensitivity, so that the temperature of the device we want to increase, we need to have a reduced value for thermal conductance. And how can we achieve it? So from one side, it must be taken into account the architecture and the design of the device. So typically, the device has long arms with a reduced cross-sectional area, and uses materials with a low thermal conductivity in order to reduce the heat dissipation through the arms. From the other side, the environment of the device is very important, and a high vacuum ambient is convenient to reduce the thermal dissipation through the gas all around the device. The fabrication of the TMOS sensor starts from a standard CMOS SOI, in which a release of the transistor will be implemented. In order to release the transistor, first of all, a backside silicon etching is performed, and following, we have a frontside dielectric etching by using the built-in masks made of metal layers of the CMOS, which will be used for masking the etching. And after the etching, they will be removed in order to reduce the thermal conductance of the system and improve the thermal performance. Once the TMOS sensor is released, it will be packaged in a wafer level package architecture in order to protect it from external environment and achieve a high vacuum level inside. The sensor will be bonded, wafer-to-wafer bonded, with glass-free bonding, with two cap wafers, a top cap and a bottom cap, which feature deep cavities. And the bottom cap features also a getter layer, which will allow to absorb all the non-noble gases coming out from the wafers. So both the getter layer and the high volume of the cavities in the two cap wafers will allow a high vacuum atmosphere in this wafer level package. Here you can see a cross section of a real device, the same cross section in which all the elements of the sensor are visible. The thermal conductance, GTH, is correlated to the thermal time constant, tau, and they are inversely proportional. Through this parameter C, which is the heat capacity of the system, and which is not influenced by the pressure of the system itself. So from the simulations of these two parameters in pressure, we can see that for low pressure values, the thermal conductance is minimum, while from the other side, the time thermal time constant value is maximum. So the interesting point is that the time constant value, we can try to measure it, and this way we can try to measure the vacuum level of the system. And to do we have implemented an electrical measurement for time constant. So, first of all, the device is configured as a diode with only two terminals in the way that the gate and the drain are connected together. And then the device is activated by a self-heating effect where a current is induced in the device. And a voltage drop is expected since the characteristic of the diode is going to change in time due to the self-heating effect. And the velocity, speed of decay of this voltage will be correlated to the vacuum level of the system. So that the tau corresponds to the time where the voltage level drops roughly 63% from the initial level. And for as an example, we can have a look here of a measurement completed on a real device, package device, with the voltage decay evaluation. Which is seen here, the measurements are in black, while the fitting line is in green. And from this fitting of this curve, the tau value can be extrapolated and measured. So, in order to characterize the time constant response for different pressure levels, so a measurement in a vacuum chamber has been completed. So in this vacuum chamber, the pressure range can be varied from atmosphere level down to very low pressure levels of 0.01 Pascal. In this vacuum chamber, two parts have been put inside. We can see here in this socket, we have the same ceramic package with two parts inside. And these parts are, one is a package reference device, and the other one is a package device which has been connected to external atmosphere through the drilling of the cap wafer. So one device which is going to be impacted by the vacuum in the vacuum chamber, and the other device which is going to be influenced from the vacuum chamber inside. So let us see which has been the result. So if we have a look at the measurements on the open part, we can see that the for high pressure values, the time constant is very low. So here we can see the pressure level in X and the thermal time constant in Y, while by reducing the pressure level, the time constant will increase and will increase and will arrive at a certain value, which is the saturation value. And at this low pressure range, all the conductance of the device will be driven by the conduction through the arms, while at high pressure, the thermal dissipation is driven by the gas. So if we compare this value of the open part with the packaged part, we can see that the packaged part is in a pressure value, a pressure range below 1 Pascal. So from this compared measurement, we can infer that the packaged value has inner vacuum level lower than 1 Pascal. So this is an example of this electrical measurement. From this characterization, the interesting point has been to implement this measurement on an industrial environment and complete the setup on an automatic probing tool in order to have a process control in production on wafer level measurements. So we have repeated testing on additional parts, and what we can see is, going from the previous chart, if we go to the values of these additional parts, we can see that all these parts have a repeatable time constant value, and all of them are in the range of time constant correlated to a pressure value lower than 1 Pascal. So this measurement has been confirmed on an automatic tool, and the high vacuum level is confirmed on additional parts. So as a conclusion, we can say that wafer level package architecture with high vacuum has been presented for uncooled infrared sensing device, and the vacuum level of the wafer level package architecture has been characterized through thermal time constant measurements. And from here, we can see that the pressure level of this package is confirmed to be lower than 1 Pascal. Moreover, these measurements have been implemented on an automatic tool in an industrial environment, which confirm the vacuum level repeatability and the effectiveness of this parameter as process control in production. So, thank you very much for your attention, and I will be glad to have some questions about these items. So, please.